Hi everyone, I am Adrian, Field Application Engineer of Nuvoton. Welcome to the M031 Level 1 training. Today I am going to introduce the sample code of Gpio. First of all, you can download the M031 BSP on the Open Nuvoton on GitHub and unzip the file. And you can find the Level 1 training under sample code. Here are the locations of the reference guide and the GPIO sample code. You can find the NuMicro driver reference guide in the document folder. Today, I will introduce the GPIO sample code to everyone. For the location of the sample project, please refer to the path below. In this sample code, we use SW1 with debounce function to control the red LED. Use SW2 without debounce function to control the green LED. The following table shows the switches, LEDs, and their corresponding GPIO on the M032SE development board. Before the demo, we would like to show you the source code of our sample code. We will go through the sample code via Kyle IDE to let you know better about it. Let's open the Kyle project file of GPIO. This slide introduces the hardware used in this demonstration. The hardware used in this demo are two boards, NuMicro M032SE and the Level 1 training board. Before the demo, we would like to show you the source code of our sample code. We will go through the sample code via Kyle IDE to let you know better about it. Let's open the Kyle project file of GPIO. At the beginning, we defined the red, green, and yellow LED, which correspond to PC4, PC5, and PC3 respectively. Because the anode of the LED is connected to the high potential, and the cathode is connected to the pin of the GPIO through a current limiting resistor, it is defined here that the GPIO output is zero. That is, when the potential is low, the LED is on. And the GPIO output 1. That is, when the potential is high, LED off. Then declare two variables representing the number of interrupts generated by SW1 and SW2. Before getting GPIO to work, there are some initializations to do. First of all, we called sysinit to initialize the clocks of system and the peripherals. Before calling sysinit, you have to unlock some registers in order to set clocks. After setting, you have to lock the registers to avoid the modifications. Before the clock source of the debounce function will need to use LIRC. Remember to turn on LIRC first in sysinit. After sysinit, we called UR0init to initialize UR0 for log message output. After initializing, below log messages could be output through UR0. Since we will use LED lights to show the operation of GPIO, we have to initialize LED as well. In LED init, we set PC3, PC4, and PC5 as GPIO function and then set the three pins as GPIO output mode. At last, set default value of all three pins as off. Next is the button init function, which initializes the SW1 and SW2 we want to use later. For SW1, first set the GPIO of BB4 with mask, and then set BB4 as GPIO input. Remember to turn on NVIC enable IRQ, and the CPU will do interrupt processing. For SW2, please refer to the setting of SW1. Then set the debounce function, select LIRC as the clock source of the debounce function. Set the clock period of the debounce sampling time to 512 clock cycles. And finally, enable the debounce function of PB4. The main function defines what we will do in this simple code. In the main program, first declare that two variables represent the number of times the buttons have been pressed, and give their initial value of 0. Unlock the system register. Initialize the system and the peripheral clocks, and lock the system register again after setting. Then call UR0init function. Print the log message of level 1 GPIO control sample code. Call the LED init function and the button init function. After that, enter the while1 loop. Check whether SW1 or SW2 is pressed, and print out the number of interruptions of the corresponding button switch. Following is the interrupt program. First of all, check if PB4 the interrupt occurred. If there is an interrupt flag, red LED is on, SW1 count plus 1, and clear PB4 interrupt flag. Then check if PB0 the interrupt occurred. If there is an interrupt flag, green LED is on, SW2 count plus 1, and clear PB0 interrupt flag. Else if other unexpected interrupt is occurred, clear all PB interrupts, and print out unexpected interrupts. The hardware used in this demo are two boards, NuMicro M032SE and Level 1 training board. Because we will use the UR transmission between the MCU and NuLink to me, we need to switch 1 and 2 of the virtual COM port switch here to on. Combine these two boards together first and then connect NuLink to me to the computer. Open the device manager on Windows and confirm the number of the USB virtual COM port. Set the corresponding COM port number in PuTTY. The baud rate is 115,200. And the connection type is selected as serial. Press open and press the reset button of M032SE. Then you can see the log message on the screen. So we can press SW1 to see the red LED light on and off, and press SW2 to see the green LED light on and off. Above is the introduction and the demo of the Level 1 training GPIO sample code. Thanks for watching. Please do not hesitate to contact us if you have questions. You may subscribe to our channel for more information.